In the last session, we have seen about the bulk oil circuit breaker, where the oil was used for two purposes, for arc quenching as well as for the insulation purpose. Now, in today's session, we will be seeing what is the need to go in for your low oil or minimum oil circuit breaker. So, if you could see the low oil circuit breaker, the main thing in the previous case, we were using the bulk oil where the weight increases and the risk of the fire also increases. So, this is the need for us to choose the low oil or minimum oil circuit breaker. Now, here if you are going to see, here the oil is going to be used only for your arc extinction purpose, whereas the insulation, outer insulation, is going to be provided by means of your solid medium such as the porcelain or the bakelite paper. Now, moving on to the construction of it, it is going to have the three chambers. One is your top chamber, circuit breaking chamber, and the supporting chamber. Everywhere it should be filled with oil. So, three chambers are there: top chamber, circuit breaking chamber, and the supporting chamber. So, if you are going to see the top chamber, it just provides a vent for the gases. Okay, and you are going to have a one gas vent on one side and the breather on the other side. Now, we will move on to your supporting chamber. So, this supporting chamber, it is nothing but it is just houses your moving contact trip. So, this trip control alone, it gives on to your down chamber, which has a drain valve. That is, if the oil is going to get deteriorated, after some time it will get drained through this. Okay, so and here the whatever is the insulation, it is going to be provided by means of the porcelain and the bakelite paper. So, this moving contact is going to be fixed through a fixed rod, okay, or a piston cylinder arrangement to the next chamber by using this rod. This is also going to be filled with the oil. Now, here you are going to have the top chamber where the concentration of the function is the obvious here. You are going to have a fixed contact, you are going to have a moving contact, and you are going to have an arc control device. In the last case, we have seen the arc splitters. Here, the arc extinction device is going to be the turbulator. Okay, so this turbulator, it is going to have both the vents. It is going to have the axial opening as well as the radial opening. So, whenever a fault occurs, initially they are going to be stuck with each other. When a fault occurs, arc is going to be struck between the fixed and the moving contact. As a result, this moving contact is going to be pulled down. In case of low fault current, this axial vent itself is sufficient enough to quench the arc. In case, if there is a fault is going to be higher, then in that case here you are going to have a radial vent also. So, which forces the oil from all the side to quench the arc. So, when I say it as a low oil circuit breaker, it is nothing but we are just going to use only 10% of the oil which we are going to use in your bulk oil circuit breaker. Thereby, you are going to use a less quantity of the oil. When I use a less quantity of the oil, there is going to be a less risk of fire and the less maintenance. Because whenever the arc is going to struck, the heat in the arc is going to decompose the oil and the carbon arc deposits are going to be in the oil itself. Okay, in that case here, this partition serves a better purpose because this partition does not allow the oil from the circuit breaking chamber to enter into the supporting chamber. Thereby, the degree of carbonization or the contamination gets reduced in your supporting chamber. Since the arcing products remains in the oil, so certain maintenance are required, though it is risk free. Okay, the main problem is due to high degree of carbonization, the oil gets deteriorated here. Okay, so the principle is that whenever a fault occurs, through this piston, this moving contact is going to be moved apart, and this turbulator is acting as an arc extinction device. Through your radial and axial vents, it quenches the arc. Okay, but main the limitation is that its maintenance process with respect to its color, the color will change, the order will change, and the contacts, there might be the burning of the fixed and the moving contacts. So, the contacts should be checked regularly, and you should check whether the oil is able to withstand 30 kV for 1 minute, okay, for a 4 mm gap between the electrodes. If that is the case, the quality of the oil is good. Now, You have also checked the outer insulation also. Then and there you have to check the oil level also, and you should also take care of the other tripping mechanisms which is associated with it. So the maintenance is quite costly in case of your oil circuit breaker, but the main advantage is that it uses less amount of the oil and less risk of fire in using this. Okay, so with this I wind up today's session. In the next session we will be seeing about the air blast circuit breaker. Thank you.